Speaking of Mena RD, we're going to get a word with him here. We're going to bring him on for a post-victory interview. There he is, looking as excited as can be. Congratulations, Bandits Mena RD.
Thank you, David. Thank you so much. Range, what's up, man?
What's good, man? I mean, so Mena, I mean, just to build upon kind of what you were looking like right now, and I was saying it with your quotes throughout Top 16 and Top 8, you've been here before, and you constantly act like you've been here before. And that's not to say, like, you're cocky or anything like that, because you don't come across that way.
You can say it.
But I don't think you do in terms of the quotes, you know what I mean? And right now, it didn't seem like a cocky pose or anything like that. It's just an aura of real confidence, you know what I mean? And I think, is that what it is?
Yes, it is. Yeah. I'm not cocky at all, because the competition is very fierce. Mm-hmm. Actually, it will seem very disrespectful to say that I'm cocky right now, that I'm extremely confident, because after that set with Mono in Winners Finals, that was extremely close, came down to just one decision, one reaction. So just got to say, I feel prepared and confident as I fight everybody, but I have to respect the competition.
Hey, you talk about respecting the competition. This basically was CPT Caribbean, and the people who made it through, 7 of the top 8 from the Dominican Republic, 13 of the top 16 from the Dominican Republic. Talk to me about your competition in your country and also in the region generally.
The competition in my country is extremely strong. Everybody always looking to, you know, be the one that's having the crown right now. Everyone knows their birdie matchup. Everyone knows my body rules, my corner picks. So the competition is very strong. As you guys can see too, the new generation of Dominican gamers is extremely strong. We didn't see the usual phases of like DRA, Crossover, Louis Man, Ho Chi dominating, but we saw Zero Stress, we saw Tang Ryu, Jimmy, you know. So a lot of the new guys, they are becoming extremely strong, and I'm very proud of that. And in the region, in general, like, we didn't see Strange Hale from Puerto Rico, a very strong player, and, you know, a lot of representation from the Caribbean, like Bahamas. I didn't see them, like Ricky J. So the competition is even stronger than this, you know. Just got to say that I'm proud of the region that I am from, and just let's keep it up.
Yeah, what was really cool to see throughout the quotes from everybody was, like, how much of a fan you all are of each other, right? Like, all the quotes throughout Top 16 and Top 8 were bigging each other up, right? We're being very impressed. You said, I'm very impressed with Hermes Venatori getting here and his improvement in his play. So, yeah, I love that the new generation of the fighting game players is getting on that elite level, and that's because of the guys like you that have set that foundation, right, and given these guys games to up their skills. And, you know, you mentioned how everyone in the Dominican Republic, everyone in Central America knows the birdie matchup, knows your variables and whatnot. And I think because of their high skill, like, the fact that they push you so hard, I feel like this is why you're as good as you are now, right? It's just all kind of an ecosystem feeding back into each other.
Yes, it is. Actually, I feel I was feeling a little, just a small amount, you know, not a toxic amount of regret of helping Mono so much in the birdie matchup. I was like, this is extremely strong in this matchup right now. I might lose, but it's going to help me a lot, you know, so... Yeah, I won't lose to any other fan that is not Monoing. I feel very good.
Well, I'm curious about that match. So you guys had a chance to play against each other last week at Evo Online, where he took it. And then now, obviously, you guys had two sets again. You took both of those sets. You're right that one of them was by literally a single decision reaction. But nevertheless, right, you come out on top. I've seen you do this before, where you lose to somebody in 1 week or at one tournament. You come back next time, and you know exactly what to do. Can you talk to me about how you make those adaptations? What changes? Not in the specific matchup necessarily, but how do you make those changes?
Well, I actually obsess a little bit when I lose. And everyone, I think, knows I'm a sore loser. So when I lose to someone, I actually just think about them the most that I can, the situations that made me lose. And I don't stop thinking about that. I can have another tournament coming up with an entirely different set of players, and I must still be thinking about that last week lost. So, yeah, I just practice a lot about the matchup. And if I have access to strong players with that matchup, then I become even stronger.
I mean, look, dude, nobody plays Fang, all right? And as you said, in your region, it's Mono. He's the Fang player. Are you playing people in the U.S.? What are you doing?
Right now, I have...
Because there's strong things in the U.S.,
I don't know if you guys have been seeing Twitter, but I have a surprise guest in my house.
No.
Yes, I do. I actually have one of the strongest Fang players in the world staying here conveniently.
What?
This guy plays Fang. This guy plays Nash. This guy plays Ed Vega. I was preparing for everyone on the go, and that guy is infiltration. He's in my house.
Oh,
right
all right then. Okay. Well, you know, you were talking about obsessing over your losses. You know, going to the lengths to get, you know, infiltration to practice with you. That is definitely making sure you know what's coming up next. You feel me? I'm
so
very impressed.
Yeah, yes, I guess.
All right, man. Well, you got any more questions for the champ? I want to let him get out of here, man. Enjoy his victory. Get back to practicing, because I know this is not the last stop, right? Of course, you're going to be going up. Yeah, this is just the beginning. So talk to us to sign it off a little bit about your thoughts going into Capcom Cup, how you're going to prepare for it, or just in general, anything you want to get off your chest.
I just want to say, you know, the Bull is going to do his thing. The Capcom Cup, as usual, is going to go very confident and more ready. I think this is the highest I have been in skill-wise, and I know I'm going to have a good result because I'm preparing a lot. Also, watch out for Bandits and Street Fighter League. Don't sleep on that because we're going to do very good. We're going to do very good. I guarantee it. And last but not least, just a few thank yous. You know, thank you to Capcom and the team, and Joshua, you know, the guys. Thank you to you guys for commentating, the people that came through and watched the stream, Central America. And just, you know, thank you to the player that helped me a lot here, Infiltration, Bandits Gaming, Blink Esports, and my family and my country. So thank you so much to all of you, and you know, that's how it is.
And thank you once again, MenRD, for giving us a phenomenal Street Fighter V play. We can't wait to see more tournaments, more life, more games from you, my man. Go on and celebrate or live the rest of your day how you will. Thank you again for joining us.